Hey, welcome back to Who May Be a Leader as we continue biblical counseling framework for life because we really do need a framework in order for us to just really be able to put our life on and really frame it up to be able to walk with God. And I think the Word of God is sufficient, because we've talked about this once before, to counsel anything that you may be struggling with or going through. Because God is our creator, and so therefore a creator must be able to really deal with what he's created. And that's the thing that we need to understand, and we need to trust God, because that's one of our biggest problem, and that's why we don't see the results that we looking for in life, because we don't truly trust God. Now, I know that's a difficult thing to do, is to trust him, is to trust anybody, because so many of us have been hurt really bad. And so when human beings hurt us, we stop trusting God, like God has allowed us to be hurt by this human being. But one of the things you got to understand, that God is not holding us as puppet. He's given us free will to choose, and sometimes we choose wrong things. Now, a lot of us get into suffering because we've invited that on us, because we're really not interacting in the Word of God like we should. And so what we do, we get what we get because we keep doing what we're doing. And God is calling us to get back to his Word, to really get back to allowing his Spirit to move within us, to teach us, to really strengthen us. And that's why he tells us to be strong in the power of his might, not in our own might. Because one of the things that I thought about the other day, if knowledge is so much power, then why are we so weak? Because knowledge is not enough, because the scriptures say knowledge puffs up, and that's all it do. Because one of the things about us as Christian, some of us, a lot of us are really into just knowing the Word of God. We need to be able to walk the Word of God and trust that God's Word is not just words, but it's also power. So I'm excited about that. Now, we talked about being an imitator of God. We talked about learning what pleases the Lord and just doing it. We talked about not being a partaker of unfruitful deeds. We also talked about what it looks like when we're walking in fruitful, the Spirit of, we talk about righteousness, truth. And so the thing about it, what we want to talk about today, is presenting our body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, because that is what we should be doing. Listen at Romans chapter 12. Therefore, I urge you, brethren, by the mercy of God, to present your body as a living and holy sacrifice acceptable to God, which is your spiritual service of worship. All that you are is a worship to God. You're a worship to God in your speech. You're a worship to God in your action. You're a worship to God in how you use your body. You're a worship to God in all ways. Once you have accepted Christ as your Lord and Savior and God as your Father, you need to present yourself to God in worship and in all sorts of ways. He say, present yourself, which is your spiritual service of worship. And do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may prove what the will of God is, and that which is good and acceptable and perfect. Now, the only way you're going to prove that God's word is what it is that you're going to have to walk in and other folks see it. That's how you're going to prove it. Now, how do you do that? I remember getting real serious at the age of 34 about walking with God. And once I decided to do that, what it did, it brought about alertness to me. I began to see things in a totally different way, because when you really looking through the spiritual eyes of God, through his word and what he say about your life, you begin to, the word of God become illuminated to you. You see things, you walking in alertness. And how do you transform your mind? Because, you know, coming up to the age of 34, I was living for the world. Now, even though I got saved at 14 and I wasn't walking with God, because I didn't know that that's what I was supposed to do. Because once I got saved and got baptized, nobody really gave me the instruction that, hey, you know, you need to get a relation and walk close with God through his word and reading of his word and really serving him through your local church. But the thing about it is, when 34 came and I became serious about walking with God and God was calling me to do certain things, I had to transform my mind, because I had the thought of the world. And so I had to transform my mind. Now, the scriptures say, be in the world, but not of it. Now, that is a difficult task. I don't care what anybody say, that is difficult. So don't confuse simple with being easy, because it sounds simple, but it ain't easy. Because what happens is, it's easier to not have done something than to do it and to have to stop doing it. Did you catch that? It is easier to not have done something, because you don't know what it tastes like. You don't know what it feel like to not have done it than to have done it and have to stop doing it. Because I remember when my wife and I got married, we was living in sin. We weren't living together, but we was sleeping together. And so what I'm saying is, we wanted God to bless our marriage, so we wanted to stop sleeping together. So what we did, we got accountability people to hold us accountable. But that was difficult, because we had been doing something and we had to stop doing it. And then not only that, the taste for it was there. See, when you don't have the taste for it, it's more easy to not do it than when you've had the taste of it and then have to stop doing it. That is a difficult thing. Now, the only way you can do that, because I believe that you move according to what you think. As a man thinketh, so is he. You move according to your thinking. And so what I'm saying to people all the time, you don't have to tell me what it is that you're thinking. All I have to do is watch your movement. And you're going to tell me through your movements and what you're thinking. You move according to what you think. And so he calling us to not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So what I want to challenge you to do is to transform your mind. Because remember, I always say, the mind is a terrible thing to face, because a lot of us don't want to face those thoughts, those ugly thoughts about us. We don't want to face that thing that we've done in the past that we don't want nobody to know. The only reason why I don't tell you the guts of my life is because I don't think really my wife can really handle some of the things that I may say here on this blog. And if you ever want to know about my life, I'm always willing to talk about it, because I don't really have anything to hide. I've made some terrible mistakes, but God is gracious, and I'm going to keep walking in accordance to what he called me to walk in, and I'm going to keep walking in his grace and his mercy until the day I die. So there you have it. We need to conform transform our mind, and the only way we're going to transform our mind, because we had a certain thought process up until the time we got saved, and God is calling us not to be partakers of this world, but to be transformed by the renewing of the mind. And so you've been used to walking with a group. I remember, you know, my brother, I told him years ago when he went to prison and then he came out, I said, you cannot continue to come out of prison and go back to the same place, the peoples that you've been hanging out with, in the same way, because what happens is you tend to fall right back into the same routine that you've been doing. It's kind of like coming in and taking a good hot shower and putting back on the nasty clothes that you just took off. God is calling us to clean ourselves up. So we have to clean up our mind in order to clean up our speech, in order to clean up our action. It's got to start with the mind first, because that's where your first battle started from. Now, we're going to continue this, because I'm excited about what we're doing here, because I think the word of God is sufficient to counsel, to comfort, and to care for you in any way that you need to, but we need to allow God to do just that. Hey, until I see you next time, may God bless you and keep you as our prayer. And remember, examine your life so you can balance your life. God bless you.